This video is part two in a series of videos on matrix functions in Excel. In Excel, matrices are referred to as arrays. Excel contains several built-in functions to assist in array calculations. These built-in functions can calculate matrix multiplication, transpose, inverse, and determinant. I'm going to do an example for each of these. Going over to my spreadsheet, first we're going to have an example of matrix multiplication. For this example, I have two matrices, matrix A and matrix B. Matrix A is a 3x3 matrix, and matrix B is a 3x2 matrix. With matrix multiplication, the inner dimensions of the multiplication must agree. For example, there is only one way that I can multiply the two of these, and that's A times B. Here you can see that matrix A being a 3x3 and matrix B being a 3x2, if multiplied in A times B order, the inner dimensions are 3 and 3, and the outer dimensions are 3 and 2. This means that when they're multiplied, we have our final dimensions, which will end up being 3x2, since those are the outer dimensions of the original two matrices. So we need to highlight out the area of this new matrix, which is a 3x2, and for matrix multiplication, there's a specific function, which is equals M mult. And in the parentheses, you have the two arrays, which in this case are A and B. Control, Shift, Enter, and there's the multiplication of the two matrices. Something to be cautious of, though. If, for example, you highlight out an area that's too wide and press Control, Shift, Enter, the extra areas will be filled with these symbols, showing that there is nothing to be put there. Also, if you highlight an area that's too small, you will get the part of the matrix that has been filled in, but the rest of it is missing. This warning also applies if you are only pressing Enter rather than Control Shift Enter. It'll only fill in the first cell rather than the entire matrix. Our next example is over transpose. In Excel, you can calculate a matrix transpose without using a built-in function. What you need to do for this is to highlight the range of cells, copy, and then right-click and paste special, and it's this button here, transpose, which will turn rows into columns and columns into rows. And as you can see, the formatting doesn't shift, but you end up with 3, 17, 1, and 12. However, there is a built-in function to do this. Here, you need to highlight the range of cells of the answer matrix, which is the same as the given one, since they're both 2x2, equals transpose of the array, Control, Shift, Enter. Now, even though it's the same size, you can tell that this row, 2, 5, has become this column of 2, 5. 10, 9, and P has become the column of 10, 9. Now next, we're going to go over the inverse of a matrix. Inverting a matrix is similar to flipping a number upside down. For example, 1/2 is the inverse of the number 2. So to calculate the inverse of a matrix, you highlight out the area of the matrix, which must always be a square matrix, and you enter equals, M inverse, and then the array. Control, Shift, Enter. This has become the inverse of this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the name to inverse underscore A, and I'm going to perform a calculation to double check. If you multiply a matrix by its inverse, you should always return with the identity matrix, which is given here. I'm going to perform that calculation. Here, I'm going to highlight out the area, equals, mult of A and inverse of A. Control, Shift, Enter. Now, as you can see, it's not exactly zero, but if it's negative 1.6 times 10 to the negative 16, it's pretty close to zero, and for our purposes, it's close enough, since there will always be rounding errors. Now, the final example I'm going to give is the matrix determinant. The determinant of a matrix is essentially a single number value that represents the entire matrix. The interesting thing with determinants is if you end up with a determinant of zero, that means the matrix you're working with is singular. So there could be a repeat row in there, or the numbers go too much in order. And if the matrix is singular, you cannot calculate the inverse of it. And as with the inverse, to calculate a determinant, you must have a square matrix. In this case, our matrix is a 3x3 matrix. So to calculate the determinant, you type equals M determ, and then the matrix. So in this case, the determinant of this matrix is 2519. And when you calculate the determinant, you do not have to press Control-Shift-Enter. you can just go ahead and press enter. Now I'm going to create a couple more examples to show the determinant. Now I have two more matrices on this spreadsheet. First is matrix B, which goes sequentially from 1 to 9, and next is matrix C, which has a repeat row in the fourth row. I'm going to calculate the determinant of both of these to prove that they're singular. Here, although it's not exactly 0, 6.6 times 10 to the negative 16 is very close to 0, showing that this is a singular matrix. If we change this last value to 8, however, this goes to 3, and it's no longer singular. Here we have a perfect 0 for our determinant, so this is also singular. To show here, if I do inverse of C, and I calculate the inverse of this array, I get an error, because since it's singular, I cannot get the inverse. However, if I were to change this row, even one number on it, it's no longer singular, and I can now have an inverse.